ode on the monochord. This shining stretch of vibrant, tuneful wire, pulled taut to teach each measured interval of song and dance and hymn. The slim monochord is lord of melody. The shimmering string is like a branch to bloom into tunes, to curl and trill in tones, gardens of melody, exhaustless glories, glimmering lines of joy. A long string's swift and glistening path, we trace the overtones and sweet stoppings that are our music. All its measurements and all its spell and heart. As he had brought it west from Babylon, Pythagoras enjoined its use in schools, and as he marked it off, so millions knew their music and modalities. His old Sumerian measurements still make the two-stepped, bright, unsettled melodies that are ancestral too, to all our modes and every tuning cycle. Archytas touched the melodious chord, and Aristophanes, who was the first of men to measure earth, these and all such men came to this instrument. Along trembling, tuneful, shining wire, we hear the careful tones that Ptolemy made in Alexandria, who wrote in numbered ratios all his tunings. The monochord is lord of melody, and such sweet division sings from its wire. So wondrous this beauty, we are moved to lord all who have made a mode.
He's got one in 12 equal over there and an awesome controller. Whole new ideas about how to arrange the keyboard. Right here is Ian Saxton, percussionist extraordinaire. He built that siren right there that he was playing and a couple